Ah, New York. What can I say except that I love it? Growing up in the South, I was shown a very specific version of this place on television and film. But to my great surprise, after living here for over a decade, I've discovered that there is so much more. My name is Allyshia, and I'm on a quest to show you a totally different side of New York and some hidden gems. So come on and get away with me, even if it's just for a day.
Once upon a time, there was a southern lady that traveled all across the land known as the York of New. Then one day, everything in the world stopped. Like most people, the southern lady grew sad as she could no longer experience all the wonders of New York land. But suddenly, after what seemed like 20 years, the southern lady was free to explore again. So on the day of her birth, she journeyed to a land of magic not so far away from home. And that magic land, known as Wings Castle, made the southern lady feel so whimsical that she decided to show everyone how they could feel the magic too.
Hi guys, welcome to another episode of Getaway for a Day with Allyshia Renay. I am here at Wings Castle in Millbrook. Y'all, do you know how long I've wanted to come visit this place? Look at it. It's like my dreams come to life. And it's actually about to rain, and that makes the ambiance that much better. So I'm gonna go ahead and show you where I'm staying for tonight. It's actually the Dungeon Suite. Okay, so you see this? This is the main castle. The annex suite where I'll be tomorrow night. And this is the piece de resistance. This is where I enter for my room for tonight. Look how cute this is, y'all. Oh my God, look at this. This is so, this is bananas, right? So if you stay here, and you have, you know, some other people with you, it'd be cool if you could say, hey, you book the dungeon, and then I'll book the suite. So let me go ahead and open my door. And welcome to the dungeon suite. Oh. This right here looks like a regular door, right? Since it's a bed and breakfast, you get breakfast every morning. And because of COVID, we can't have the continental breakfast in the main room. So they put it in here for you the day before. Muffin, bagel, oh, little nectarines. Tangerines, one of them. Ice, yogurt. And then you know me, I brought my own food. This door, I'm told, goes to a laundry room. This door is actually a nice little closet. I already put my things in there, of course. And this door leads to a very beautiful bathroom. Look at that. Wow. You have a walk-in shower. Very nice. I mean, they even made the wind. Look at this. The mirror looks like it's old, but it's not. Yes, so guys, first night down. All I can say is this place is magical. It's like my dreams come to life. I mean, I'm staying in a place that actually looks like a castle, but it's a home. It's a home to the Wing family. And it's very quiet, very peaceful. If you are a writer or you just need to get a break from the rigmarole or it's busy, especially if you live in New York, guys, this is the place to be. I'm definitely going to get some good sleep tonight. I brought my snacks because, again, as I said, this is a B&B. You do get the breakfast, but most people drive here, so they usually go out for lunch and or dinner. But I brought my own snacks, so I'm good for tonight. And I'll be good for tomorrow as well because the Annex Suite has a full kitchen. And I'll bring that to you a little bit later. All right. Good night, y'all. This room is cute, cozy, with a side of sexy. But I will say that if you are over 6 feet tall, just be a little careful because the ceilings are a little low. But I guess that's what gives it the intimate quality. Oh, you had to know I came back, right? I wanted to check out another room, and the chamber room is equally as cozy as the dungeon room.
The entire castle was designed and built by my late husband, Pete Wing. It was started in 1970, a month after we were married. Our goal was simply to build ourselves a home. We wanted to live in a castle. We wanted to have a moat. This is what Peter came up with. What we thought was a two-year project took us 22 years to put here. Peter had never built a thing in his life prior to the castle. He had never done any masonry or carpentry work, and he had no formal training in art or architecture. He was a farm boy, and the farm below us, which is now the Millbrook Winery, was the Wing family farm for over 100 years. This was the back cow pasture of the old farm, which is what put us here to build. Now, at the age of 23, coming up here, we had absolutely no funds to build anything. And that steered us toward recycled materials. So the castle is built with roughly 80% recycled materials. And there were three major sources we were pulling from. First of all, barns. We were buying barns, dismantling them before it was vogue. People weren't doing that yet. For us, it was a source of material. And we would buy a barn, take it apart piece by piece, and bring all the materials here. Hand-hewn beams, floorboards, barn siding, doors, hinges, nails. We took the nails out of the board and straightened them. We were so desperate for material. We did that 13 times altogether. And you know, while Peter and I were collecting the materials, he was also working on the structure. This is a basic stick structure like every home you see built. New cement blocks, studs, rafters, plywood, sheetrock, insulate, wire it, plumb it. You've got a home. That's what he did. Then he surrounded it inside and outside with the older materials, giving it the look and feel of age. You know, he knew he wanted it sound. He knew he wanted it livable. You could have a 20-foot stone wall between you and the outdoors. You'd freeze to death. You needed it insulated. You needed the wooden structure and the airspace and then the stone. You know, Pete wasn't a mason or a carpenter. He wasn't an architect. You know, he'd come out here with a sketch every day and he'd say, this is what we're doing today. And you know, by the end of the day, it looked just like that sketch. So that's how this progressed. But he was an artist, and that's what gave him, he had this vision. He knew how to make this look like it was here for centuries, not the five decades that it has been here. So it was the artist that was able to accomplish this. Peter worked on this, all of this section that we're about to wander through, for the next 22 years by himself, pecking away at this. Now, he started the exterior first on this. When I say that, the stonework. He went around the entire circumference, and then he connected the two with this tunnel, because in his mind, this was always one big castle. This isn't two separate units, it's one castle. He went up through this tunnel, up a staircase, which is absolutely gorgeous, did the ceilings, did the wall, ready to open the door the very next day when he had a fatal car accident. Within an hour, he was gone. You know, these are the surreal things that happen in life that just, you go from one thing to the next. Within, I would say, 3 months, our son came home, walked into this, said, well, you know, you can't rent it like this. It was just a skeleton, you know, of studs and rafters, no floor plans, no blueprints. Peter had all that in his head. He knew exactly, but we didn't. Charles said, I'm going to finish that so you can rent it. So he went into it. And he designed the interior and did all of the physical work that you see in there. Aww. Now, come right on in. Peter created this space as a common meeting area for guests, a place to come, to sit, to relax. The roof on this is the bottom of an old water tower that he purchased from the Pleasant Valley Dye Factory.
Oh, my gosh.
The stained glass windows he made from scratch. The Buddha behind you folks, Peter carved out of stone. It is a working fireplace. You're welcome to, you know, enjoy it. It's wonderful when you come in here and the fire's going and you light all these candles. It's quite magical.
I love the eyes in this one.
Yeah, this sculpture is actually a self-image.
What?
Peter made this up from natural stone that he collected.
Wow.
You know, he didn't carve this at all. But he would see things in nature that looked like cheekbone or, you know, an eyeline or whatever. And he'd set them here and he'd say, now, don't touch those if you're getting any little rubble, because often you needed little stone. Leave that pile there. And then all of a sudden, one day he took it and he created this. Now, if you ever saw Peter in his later years, his hair was very thick. It was silvery gray and it was curly. And then when it got long, it was just like out here. It was just boom, you know. He looked like Einstein, actually, in his later years. Another common meeting area that Peter started, he didn't get to finish this. Charles will create something in here to complete it, and he's got a wonderful idea. Peter it did get all the benches and the tables done, and he welded all this iron together, planning to parch over it and drip stalactites off of it. So you'd really feel like you were in a cavern, you know? The floor here, Charles temporarily put here, but there under it, there are steps that go down into this big pit and benches. Peter was creating a hot tub. We have scratched that idea, but we'll certainly do something very interesting here that Charles has. I think this has inspired a lot of people to maybe go and try something. They've said to me, I just feel like I could do something now, or that thing I've been putting aside, I might try it. Which is also one of the reasons we keep it open to people. I mean, this needs to be seen. This is a piece of art. It's a live-in art project. And, you know, you can't take it to a gallery. You can't show it in any other way. You've got to bring people here. So needless to say.
Okay, guys, so we did a tour this morning, and it was so nice and so beautiful. I had to come back out here so that I could get a better look at the place. And I'm telling you, this place is like my dream come true. Look at this. Wow. Ugh, look at that. Ugh, it's cute. Oh my goodness.
What am I doing here by myself?
Oh, okay. Okay. Oh my God, oh my God. I cannot tell you guys how much I needed this right now. This place is absolutely beautiful.
Wow.
I could stand up here all night. Look at
you can actually swim underneath that, y'all. Oh, I can't wait to come back next year.
How are you?
Good, how you doing?
I'm good. I just want to say thank you for opening your doors during these weird times and letting me come in to talk to you.
Our doors are always open for you guys and everybody else who's watching.
Awesome. Now tell me who you are and tell me about this lovely vineyard.
So my name's Jake. I'm the front of house manager here at Millbrook Vineyards and Winery in Dutchess County, New York. And I want to show you guys what we make and what we enjoy here. Our doors are open to you 361 days a year, 7 days a week, noon to five at the least. We produce about 16,000 cases of wine a year, of which I know I can find some that you will love, as well as all your other people will love, whether you're a 30-year wine vet or it's your first time coming to a winery. Besides the wine itself, June, July, and August, we do our food truck Fridays. We bring in three local food trucks. It switches up every week. There's no cost to that. You guys come up, enjoy the view of the vineyard, enjoy the view of the valley. It's only about an hour and a half, 2 hours max from Manhattan, Brooklyn, Bronx, or Queens, or maybe even Staten Island if you're all the way out there. But I guarantee out of the 27 different wines that I make here, I know I could find you guys some that you'll love.
Is there anything specific you want to show us today?
So one of the things that I want to show you guys is something besides what you may think of Millbrook when you come up to Millbrook.
Okay.
So besides, like I said, the 27 wines that we say is Millbrook or the Hunt Country brand, mm-hmm. I want to show you guys something over here called our Pebble Ridge brand.
Okay.
So my boss, John Dyson, who's actually head of New York City Power Authorities way back in the day, mm-hmm. owns another property called Pebble Ridge Vineyards.
Okay.
What we do is it's an 850 acres of just vines, just grapes. We bring the top cream of the crop from California to Millbrook.
Really?
Doesn't come to us in juice, comes to us in 1-ton containers of fruit, just grapes. We de-stem it, press it, if it's a red, we'll macerate it, ferment and bottle it all right here. So as much as it says, Pebble Ridge, California, devil's in the details. Bottled and produced, Millbrook, New York, 12545.
Wait a minute. Okay, so you're teaching me something new. So if they got grapes from Millbrook, took them to California, they would have to say it's a New York wine?
You better believe it.
So it doesn't matter where it was made. It matters where the fruit comes from. Well, I'll be dog.
Mm-hmm. So that's one of the cool things is we don't just want to sell you wine because it's wine. I want to teach you what this wine is, why it tastes the way it tastes, and why you might like something else. If you don't like something I make, I can give you something that's well known and readily available for you to sample somewhere outside of my facility so that you can enjoy wine and kind of grow into it. Because that's one of the other things is it's sometimes hard to dive right into a glass of wine or maybe even a bottle of wine. So we take the extra step to help you find something that you like, maybe not just my product.
So we are now upstairs.
Yep.
Jacob, what is this place?
So this is called our loft. So every weekend out of the year, we'll be doing tastings up here on the second floor inside. Everybody's spaced out because all the craziness that we're going through right now. This is originally a dairy barn. So this is a dairy barn that my boss, John Dyson, was able to recreate into our tasting facility. When we're not doing it for tastings or if we have the availability, we do plenty of events. Corporate parties, birthday parties, weddings, anniversaries, family reunions, whatever you guys want to use this space for, it's available. We do 20% off the wine when you do an event here, so that's kind of a big kickback, but this is the place to check out when you come here. What's cool about this place is even though we have about 22,000 people coming through here on a normal year, we have a core family that works here. I mean, I am one of 9 full-time employees here, and I only got 15 part-time employees. We come in, we trudge through, we meet a lot of cool people from all over the world, all over the state, all over the country, and you just have to make it through. Because you can't leave wine uncorked. You have to enjoy it all.
I like it.
And when you run out, you just gotta come back and say hi to us, that's it.
Okay. Oh, Jacob, thank you so much.
Yeah.
Yeah, this has really made my day.
Well, good. Well, hopefully we'll see you guys soon.
Yes. Bye. Okay, guys. So last night, I stayed in the dungeon room, and this hallway leads to the annex suite upstairs. Can you believe it? the annex suite. Ooh! Let's go in and see what this is all about, shall we? Oh, yo. This is just the entrance, guys. Oh my goodness. And you do remember earlier, I said this was the entrance to the underground passageway to the dungeon room. Hello, hello, hello. Look who's here to greet me. This is not just a suite. This is a whole house. And it is beautiful. So when I say it's a whole house, I mean it has a full kitchen. It has a bedroom, bathroom. You saw the dining room when we came in here. I just, look at that. A full range with an oven. You even have some spices, olive oil. Oh, you know this is a good house that has olive oil. Utensils. And look at these stairs. Every detail in this house is beautiful. And this is where they keep the extra dishes, the place settings. Look at these antique pots, or old school pots like grandma used to have. Coffee, toast. And let's not forget, you have a microwave, refrigerator with food in it. And you better believe I'm making eggs tomorrow. Word of caution. When staying somewhere like this, do not contact scary family members who say things like, oh, you're staying there all by yourself? Not a good look. But anyway, let's go. Let us see what is up the stairs. Like, guys, I want you to, I'm gonna step back for a minute. Oh my God, look at that. That's like some Pirates of the Caribbean stuff. Or Caribbean, depending on how you want to say it. Here's the bathroom. Oh my goodness. Very nice. Look at that window. Wow. Oh my goodness, look at this. Dang. They went all out in this place. This mirror. Oh, beautiful. Okay, so I'm getting ready to go into the bedroom, and these are some grand doors to get into this bedroom. And I'm interested to see what it looks like. Let's go take a peek. Oh my gosh. I like this. This is like over in Europe, like maybe Strasbourg or something like that. Oh my goodness, I like. And this place, unlike the dungeon room, comes with a television. Yay. So I will be watching something tonight. Oh my goodness, look at that bed. Wow. Nice. Oh, Charles was kind enough to come and light the fireplace for me because you know I couldn't do it. So I'm gonna sit back and watch this thing crackle as the night winds down. So I'm making a quick little breakfast, and they have everything you need here. Making an egg and cheese omelet. They provided the eggs, I provided the cheese, and I'm also going to add in a little Sausalito turkey. And I'm done. Got my omelet and English muffins provided by Wings Castle. I think I did pretty good. What do y'all think?
The circle you're standing in was formed from the foundation of the oldest Wing family homestead in Dutchess County. And that was down on Route 22 in Wingdale, New York, a township founded by this family. They came here in 1632. A mother with four sons from England, they came into Sandwich, Massachusetts, and one son left there, came into Dutchess County and started that township. Under his home, these were the foundation stones. You are seeing half of every stone as it was cut and utilized at that point in time. As you stand here, you're looking due west out toward Mohonk and the Schwangunk Mountains of New Paltz. Off to the right, you have the Catskills. Down here on the left is Storm King Mountain.
Guys, you see this light on me? I was praying to God that I would get a sunset like this. And he answered my prayers. Look at this. Oh my gosh. Baby. Woo. Lord have mercy. I'm sorry to be so country, y'all, but this is so beautiful. Yes! Look at the light on the castle. So, I think that's it for me for this episode of Getaway for a Day with Allyshia Renay. I mean, this place was, it was just what I needed. It was everything I thought it would be from the pictures online and probably even more. If you want to get away from the city, relax, and feel like you're stepping into another world, come here. So I hope you enjoyed this episode of Get Away for a Day, journey into this land of magic with me, Allyshia Renay. But don't fret, come on back for the next episode, my friends, even though this fantastic journey has now come to an end. Bye, y'all.